Well, okay. Master Spat Flute. We have a little less than our full time. And there were no questions. We worked on the last move, last class. There were no questions about anything else. So let's run it a few times, review that last move, and then run it a little more. Walk through pace, begin. One, strike. Two, grab, push. Three, kick. Four, turn, straight down. Shove, row. Under, under. Over, over. Row, shove, helicopter. Up and over. Oh, speeding up, sorry, walk through. Unwind and row. Shove. Turn, strike, up and over. Unwind and row. Shove. Turn and strike. Over the head. Turn and strike. Grab, step back, high one. Back high two. Back low three. Back low four. Back high five. Back high six. Back low seven. Back low eight. Sink to the left, turn to the right, step left, right, step left, right. Okay, shake it out. If you got stuck or if you got lost, remember where that place was. Think about what might happen that you forgot. Be careful that the place you get stuck doesn't turn into like a thing. Sometimes that can happen as you get tense when you get to the part that you know you forgot before and then you forget again. So think through it before. And if not, congratulations, good job. Let's do it one more time, walk through. One, strike. Two, pull, push. Three, pull, kick. Four, turn, strike. Continue. Under. Over, over, row, shove, helicopter, up and over, and wind, row, shove, turn, strike, up and over, unwind, row, shove, turn and strike, loop the loop, turn and strike. Up, high one, high left two, low right three, low left four, high right one, high left two, low right three, low left four. Sink on the left, hit it on the right, circle step. Okay, cool. I hope that went well for you. If it didn't, and there's something I can help you with besides, like, I just need to keep doing it over and over, let me know. I'll try to clear it up. Okay, let's review that last move. Starting position for the last move. Left foot forward, weight's on the left, right, all of the foot, some weight, but more is on the front than on the back. The flute's in the right hand because we're doing the striking part, but it came from, well, it came low up to your left shoulder, struck from your left, so it still has kind of that angle. Think about that temple level strike. Left hand's in prayer position. And as we broke it down last time, lead with this move with the back of the flute. So sink, hold on your left, lead. Flip it around, turn to the right, leading with it on the right. Keep turning, commit, pull up the left knee, step left, and then when you step in, poke forward. And that's your chance to switch hands, let go of the right. Right together, a couple more times. Sink. Turn. Left. Right. Go left. Right. Bow. One more time. Sink. Turn. Step left. Right. Left. Okay, No questions were submitted about this move, but I'll show it from the other angles again, briefly. It's kind of from the side, it starts facing you, it ends up facing that way. So, sink down to the left, turn, pivot, step left, right. Does that make sense from that angle? I don't know. I'll do it facing, oh wait, that's the normal way. I'll do it facing this way and end up facing the camera. Oh yeah, you might not have seen this side. Well, almost the camera, a little to the left. You're right, stage left. Okay. So, nothing's coming to mind for other sort of guidelines. Maybe a reminder of why we do the form. Because this gets a little lost once the task becomes memorizing the form and then doing the moves quote-unquote correctly. The original goal might get lost. And what was the original goal? Well, do you remember? I'm giving you a chance to think of it and say it, yell it at the screen or something, I don't know. The goal is to extend our empty hand Tai Chi body awareness to a tool or an implement. That's what I'm calling this thing. So yeah, so whereas you are learning without the weapon, pretend I don't have it in my hand, you're learning to connect to the fingertips with balanced, coordinated, correctly connected motion. Now extend that awareness up to the tip of the weapon. I don't know why I emphasized it like that. Maybe stick in your brain. So, there's not a lot of it on this last move, to be honest, but as you go through where you're striking and things like that, see if you can feel that same awareness as if your arm extended out through a third joint. Okay, well, let's do one more walkthrough, and then we'll do a more speedy version for those that want to try along, and those that don't, you can just watch or cut the video at that point. One more walkthrough version. Up and over, walk through pace, unwind, row, shove, turn, strike, loop-de-loop, turn, strike, wind up, and one, and two, and three, and four, and five, and six, and seven, and eight. I start to have fun with the form, you see it sometimes gets faster. I'm sorry. Let's do it one more time, but intentionally faster. Watch it or do it, either would be informative. And I'll only call out cues when I know you're facing away from the screen so you don't look over your shoulder. Otherwise, let's just move it again. Begin. And shove. Row, under, under, over, over, row, shove, helicopter, up and over, unwind and row, shove, turn, up and over, unwind and row, shove, turn, up and over. Oh, I just repeated in an infinite loop. Apologize for that. Let's go back to here, loop de loop. And turn. High, one. High, two. Low, three. Low, four. High, one. High, two. Low, three. Low, four. Close and move. Okay, a little hiccup in there. Apologize for that. You could just keep going around if you get to come out of, forget to come out of that. Oh man, we're out of time. All right, Master's Path beginners. Good luck with your flute practice. Hope it's going well. Let me know if I can help you in any other way. Very good. Okay, Master's Path dismissed.